If you're looking for a unique way to style your blogs, I'm gonna create a design that would be perfect for you to hook your audience, okay? So the first one we will do is we will create a fixed sidebar into your blog, and also I will teach you that how you can make that fixed sidebar dynamic. So if you are interested in that, stay tuned because I'm gonna show you how. 1, 2, 3.
So this is our Instagram vibe. So, but what I'm gonna teach you is the inner post. So if you click our articles in here, you will see that these related articles are in fixed mode. And at the same time, I will also teach you. So that is the first one that we will cover, is we will create a sidebar that is fixed. And then the other one that we will cover as well is we need to make sure that this blog that shows on the inner post should be relevant. So this article is all about style tips. So what should show up into the up next sidebar should be also a style tips category. Okay, so I'm going to teach you how you can do that. Okay, to do that, go into your Divi and then theme builder. Okay, but first, by the way, you need to make sure that you set up your category. Okay, so I created a new category earlier called I think it's called celebrities, because we don't have. So I created this new articles or category rather. Celebrities. So we will set up this template. So to do that, you click the add new template, and then you go to the post specific category and you choose the category that you created. Okay, so you click the add custom body and click that one. Okay, and click the build from scratch. And then I will choose the 3/4 by 1/4 layout. Let me just save that one. I will copy all the layouts in the 3/4 because what we will only cover is the sidebar area. So, but if you want me to create another tutorial for that, let me know. Just comment down below, as always. So let me save that one, and I'm gonna open any of templates in here, and I will copy all of this stuff. I will just copy this part and we will build this one from scratch later. Okay, so save. Let's go back in here, and then let's just copy everything instead. I'm gonna copy that, and then we will just remove this one so you know, like, so it makes sense. Okay, so how you can do that part, so click the plus gray icon to create a new module, and then let's look for a blog module. Okay, so since this articles is all about celebrities, I'm going to choose the celebrities category. So all of the articles in here should be only recent celebrities, okay? So I'm going to remove all of the elements except the featured image. So let's remove all of this, okay? And also for the excerpt and for the pagination, because I only want to see one sample. And for this one, if you don't want to see this part, you can also go to the display. Sorry, it should go to the custom CSS. And then you come to the title and type display none. Okay. So if you really want to have an Instagram vibe, so you already have that. Because I want to make this, all of the elements inside the sidebar to be fixed, what I do is I head over to this sidebar column, okay, the second column. So this is our first column, the free fourth, and this is the one fourth column. So go to the settings and then go to the design and go to the, sorry, it's not design, rather it's advanced. So in the scroll effects, you select this part, and then I also set an offset in here to be in 64px, so it won't, if they go into the footer, they have like enough space. Similar with the sidebar, I think our header size is 60px, so I set up an offset of 60px for the sidebar, so it has an enough space, not sidebar, header, so it has an enough space at the top. Okay, so just follow this one, so it should only stick to the section area, so this part. Okay, you can also make the body area or the row, but again, we don't want this to overlap to our footer, so you can keep that like that. We don't want to overlap this one on the header section for the top, and for the bottom part, we don't want to overlap this on the footer areas. So we're already good in the desktop, but if we put, like, we switch that into mobile version or tablet version, it will look really bad because it's just sticking at the top. So what you can do is, instead of choosing the stick to bottom part, you can keep that do not stick. Also similar with the mobile section, it should be do not stick. For the desktop, we want to make it sticky, so you just need to change this part, okay, so it doesn't overlap to your entire post. So if you're already contented with the design, you can reuse this layout by saving it. So you I'm gonna call this one blog template, and I'm gonna put that on the category. And you, if you want to set up a new category, you can do so, but we already have a blog category, so check that one and save to library. Now, for example, you want to implement that design on your other blog categories. So let's say I'm going to remove this one, this layout from the style tips. What you can do is, instead of clicking the or choosing the build custom body, you can just click the add from library, and you go to your save layouts, and you choose the layout that you have saved. So on my end, we click this blog, and then this is the layout that we created. Now, of course, like, this layout the layout is fine, but the category in this part, you need to change that to its respective category. So since this blog category is all about style tips, so click the gear icon, and instead of choosing celebrities, let's click the style tips. Also, I have a tutorial. I'm gonna publish new tutorials for in this part. So if you want to make your articles, your thumbnails squared or other dimension, I'm gonna provide you a tutorial on that, because by default the thumbnails for the blog Divi template is landscape.
I hope this has been helpful, and as always, I do have a lot of videos related to Divi, so make sure you check my playlist. I'm gonna put it on the link description below, or put it in here.